Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to interact and experience together. We're going to have our biology form 1 lesson 19, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic in nutrition in plants and animals, and a subtopic adaptations of the leaf to its photosynthetic function. Remember, in our previous lessons we dealt with photosynthesis or the internal structure of the leaf, and now in this lesson we're going to look at how the leaf is adapted for it to be able to carry out the photosynthetic function. So I appeal that if you not watch our previous lesson, which is lesson 18, you go back and watch it. We are going to have lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson you should be able to give the adaptations of the leaf to its photosynthetic function. There are several adaptations of the leaf to its photosynthetic functions. As in, these adaptations are enabling the leaf for it to be able to carry out the photosynthetic function. So the first adaptation is that the leaf has got a broad flat lamina, which provides a large surface area for absorption of carbon dioxide and sunlight. We have our second one, whereby the thinness of the leaf allows light and carbon dioxide to pass through a short distance to reach the photosynthetic cells. Remember, the leaf, which is the margin of the leaf, is very thin. This thinness, it allows the leaf for light to pass very quickly through a short distance to the photosynthetic cells. We have also on both the upper and the lower part of the leaf, it has got stomata. So the presence of this stomata ensures efficient diffusion of carbon dioxide into the leaf. Remember, for photosynthesis to take place, carbon dioxide is very essential. So it gets into the leaf through the stomata. We're going to have our fourth adaptation of the leaf, which is everybody going to get the cuticle. And the cuticle and epidermis, they are transparent enough to allow penetration of light to the palisade cells. So the cuticle and the epidermis, they are very transparent, such that light passes, it penetrates to the palisade cells. We're going to have a continuation of the adaptation of the leaf, the photosynthetic function, whereby our fifth adaptation is that the palisade cells contain large, numerous number of chloroplasts, and the arrangement and location next to the upper epidermis enables them to receive maximum sunlight. As you are aware that the chloroplast, it is where photosynthesis takes place, and they are many, or they are maximum in the upper epidermis. This is for them being in the upper epidermis, it will enable them to receive maximum sunlight, unlike in the lower epidermis, because I know that the light rays, they don't maximally reach the lower side of the leaf. We have also the existence of extensive veins that contain vascular bundles which conduct water and mineral source to the photosynthetic cells. These ones, they will be able to remove the products of photosynthesis. Remember, photosynthesis is a process, and it has its raw materials, and also it has got the byproducts of photosynthesis. For example, the carbon dioxide. So it is the function of the extensive veins, which will remove the products of photosynthesis. We have also the spongy mesophyll layer cell, the cells of the spongy mesophyll, which are loosely arranged, leaving large intercellular air spaces that are interconnected for rapid diffusion of carbon dioxide in the cells. As you can see, the spongy mesophyll layer, it contains cells which are loosely arranged. And now, because we are dealing with the photosynthesis, here we are going to observe the chloroplast. We are going to have a look at the chloroplast, because it is whereby the photosynthesis in plant takes place. In our diagram here, we have a diagrammatic representation of the chloroplast. And as you can see, it is the outer membrane, the plant cell structure. This is the, we have the, got the outer membrane. We also have the inner membrane. We have the stroma, which consists of the lamellae. We have the granum, in plural, it's known as the grana. We have in the membrane space, we have the thylakoid. So they are disc-shaped organelles found in the cytoplasm of some plant cells. So you must note that the chloroplasts, they are disc-shaped and they are found in the cytoplasm of some plant cells. The reason why we are saying some plant cells is because it is not all plants that have got chloroplast, because remember there are some non-green plants whereby they don't carry out the process of photosynthesis, and you know that the function of the chloroplast is to carry out it is the site for photosynthesis. Having done that, remember we have, I guess we have our figure there, we have explained about the chloroplast. Now having done and said that, we're going to have an activity whereby you should give the adaptations of the leaf to its photosynthetic function, and you also draw and label the structure of the chloroplast as we have seen in our topic. For further reference on our topic or our lesson, you can refer to KLB Secondary Biology Students Book 1 for the edition Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. And also for more information, you can send us an SMS through the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message on Facebook, which is at Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _Kenya. Thanks for watching, and let us subscribe to the channels that are appearing on our screen for us to learn more. Thank you for your time and welcome.